Hello everyone, I am Surendra Jain, Master Teacher in Vedanta, and I am presenting you the solutions of JEE Advanced 2020. This is question number 11 from paper 1 from the topic 3D, which is very, very important for JEE Advanced. We have seen multiple questions from this topic in JEE Advanced. Let us see what this question is. L1 and L2 are the two lines given by x minus 1 upon 1 equal to y upon minus 1 equal to z minus 1 upon 3 and x minus 1 upon minus 3 equal to y upon minus 1 equal to z minus 1 upon 1, and the third line L, which is x minus alpha upon L equal to y minus 1 upon m equal to z minus gamma upon minus 2, lies in the plane containing L1 and L2 and passes through the point of intersection of L1 and L2 if the line L bisects the acute angle between the lines L1 and L2, then which of the following statements is R2? And options are given in terms of unknowns alpha, gamma, L and M. So let us see how to solve this question. First of all, if we read this question carefully, we immediately notice that L1 and L2 are given such that their point of intersections are known directly. And this is 1, 0, 1. Why I am saying so? If you see, these two have same numerator, x minus 1, y, z minus 1, and here also x minus 1, y and z minus 1. Okay, so 1, 0, 1 lies on both the lines. So we know point of intersection of these two, and in fact this also lies on the line L. Now, second information they have given, that L bisects the acute angle between the lines L1 and L2. Now, how to find acute angle direction or acute angle direction ratios of L? Let us see. To find this, I am drawing a diagram in which line L1 is like this, line L2 is like this. Point of intersection we are already aware. Now we can say a vector along L1 can be 1, minus 1, 3. This is actually the direction ratios of L1. Similarly, a vector along L2 can be minus 3, minus 1, 1. If I call them as A and B, you can notice that A and B are such their magnitudes are equal to root 11, which means A and B here, they are vectors of equal magnitude. Now there is one very, very important thing regarding vectors of two equal magnitude, that if you add them, suppose these are two vectors, one is A, one is B, and if you take A plus B, it should be lying along their angle bisector, means this angle will be equal to this angle. So here also we can find angle bisector of A and B by adding them. Okay, but there is an important question here: will that angle bisector be acute or will that be obtuse? Because if we add them in this diagram, A plus B will be along this, and we are not sure whether this angle will be acute or not. If this angle is obtuse, then maybe we will have to go for this direction. Okay, and in this case, if we have to go, we will be taking by A minus B or by B minus A. Okay, because you can write this as minus A, so this direction will be B minus A. Okay, so we have to check whether A and B are having acute angle between them or they are having obtuse angle between them. To do this, I am taking the dot product between A and B, and if you do this, you will get this product to be minus 3 plus 1 plus 3, which is 1, that is positive, and hence angle between A and B is acute. So this A plus B will be able to give me the direction along their acute angle bisector, and A plus B I just have to add corresponding direction ratios, so it becomes minus 2 here, minus 2 here, and 4 here. Let me just check. Minus 3 plus 1, so minus 2. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. 1 plus 3 is 4. Or you can also write this as 1 comma 1 comma minus 2 after simplification. Because minus 2 was common, so we can write like this also. Now, this L is also having direction ratios as L, M and minus 2, in which third direction ratio here and third direction ratio here, they are same. So we can directly write L to be equal to 1 and M to be equal to 1. Okay, so one part we have done. Now we will try to find alpha and gamma. Let us see how. The line L is given such that we can say alpha comma 1 comma gamma lies on it, which is definitely different from the point 1 comma 0 comma 1. If you remember, this 1 comma 0 comma 1 is the point of intersection of L1 and L2, and this also lies on L. But these two are different because their y coordinates are different. So to get alpha and gamma, I am going to write this line L as x minus alpha upon 1 equal to y minus 1 upon 1 equal to z minus gamma upon minus 2. We have already found L and M to be 1, 1. Okay, and we take this as equal to lambda, one very standard approach. Okay, this will give you a variable point lying on this line. Lambda plus alpha, lambda plus 1, minus 2 lambda plus gamma. Now to know the values of alpha and gamma, I am equating this point to be as 1 comma 0 comma 1. 1 comma 0 comma 1. Okay, now if we compare y coordinates, we get lambda equal to minus 1. And if we put this lambda equal to minus 1 for x coordinate, we get alpha to be equal to 2. And similarly for z coordinate, if I put lambda equal to minus 1, this 2 plus gamma will be equal to 1, and hence gamma will be equal to minus 1. So we have found alpha gamma also. Already we had found L is equal to 1 and M is equal to 1. Now to know which option is correct, let us go to that slide where options are written. We have found L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1, alpha is equal to 2, and gamma is equal to minus 1. Let me just verify. L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1, alpha is equal to 2, gamma is equal to minus 1. That's correct. So alpha minus gamma is 3. So option A is correct. L plus M is 2. Yeah, so B option is correct. Alpha minus gamma cannot be 1. L plus M cannot be 0. So A and B are correct. Let us see what answer they have given. Yeah, A and B are correct. So this completes the solution. Okay, thank you so much and stay tuned for next question.